Hello, I'm Alejandro Peña, and I'm going to explain this poster that describes the work resulting from the collaboration between the Clinical Biomechanics Laboratory of Andalusia of the University of Malaga and the Institute of Orthopaedic Research and Biomechanics of the Yale University Medical Center. This work studies the changes in the composite relaxation properties of the meniscal horn under combined axial compression and circumferential traction, meaning the physiological loading state of the meniscus. Previously, other studies have extensively studied the composite properties of human menisci, but the impact of tensile loading on the composite properties is unknown. To our knowledge, this is the first work to focus on it. For this purpose, an undestructed indentation test has been carried out on 27 meniscal horns in 3 circumferential tensile loading states, allotted 10 N and 20 N, in order to analyze the relaxation behavior in each traction condition. Each horn was sutured with surgical thread using a simple stitch simulating a root repair and allowing to apply the pulling force to the horn. In the cranial surface around the suture hole, 7 measurement points were marked using a tissue marker, and for each loading state, the maximum force and the relaxation modulus in the relaxation period have been studied. For the statistical analysis, an ANOVA test was used to find global difference, and when this was detected, a student's T-test with one phoronic correction between pairs of roots was performed. After the test, significant differences were found between the two circumferential traction levels of 10 N and 20 N with respect to the unloaded state in both parameters. However, no difference were found between the 10 N and 20 N loading states. Therefore, with the results, we can conclude that the values obtained with isolated compression should not be transferred to physiological loading conditions that involve combined traction and compression. And it's necessary to mention that this study focused on suture repair meniscal roots, and further research is needed to confirm whether the results are applicable to healthy meniscal root with natural anchoring. So, finally, we would like to thank the University of Malaga and the Government of Spain for the funding. And if you have any questions, I will be happy to answer them on Monday, 1st of July at the poster session. So, thanks for listening.